Alright guys, good morning. Want to start off this video a little bit different and show you guys something that I utilize in my life to make sure that I'm staying on point with the diet. So it is 9:22. I just got to work. And what I have here is a meal prep container with 2 cups of white rice and a blender bottle. Shout out to Body Art. With 2 scoops of protein, so 60 grams of protein. I utilize things like to-go containers and blender bottles and whatnot as a way to make sure that I can eat the foods that I need to while on the go. And the reason I showed you this, because I brought the white rice as is. I know we have ground beef here at the 507, so I'll pay for that. And then just cook some and put it on top of there. I didn't have to make the whole meal last night. I actually made that white rice in the meal that I showed you guys yesterday. If you guys haven't checked out that video, I showed chicken tenders with white rice and some veggies. So I just made extra white rice so I can make sure I had some for this morning. So utilizing things like that and just thinking ahead is what's gonna help you in the long run. And then the protein, I know I like to have at least 1 protein shake in the morning to get me going and to make sure I'm right on track towards my goal. And so something like this helps out a lot. So that's a quick tip. Let's go to the gym. All right, what's going on guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. It's Friday. I already did the intro. I don't know why I'm doing it again. We're at the gym now. And so I'm gonna take you guys through like my warm up on a bench day. I know I've talked about it before, but I'll give you guys like the actual details. So I always start I try to start with the bike for my first warm up. And this is something to just get my whole body moving, pumping away. I normally do 5 minutes, nothing too crazy. I normally lean back on my phone, sipping my pre-workout. Every once in a while, I'll kick it up for like 30 seconds, just go super hard. But for the most part, I'm just chilling. In 1 minute, I burned 4 calories. So, like I said, just chilling. Just getting the blood moving in my body after not doing too much. And then I'll take you up to what I'll do next. All right, so after I get off the bike, the next 2 things I will do, superset it together, is a tricep extension of any sort and a shoulder press or lateral raise of any sort. I choose these because my warm up for bench will warm up all those together, but I feel like my shoulders and tricep especially need to be extra warm before we get going, and then I'll be fine. So I'm about to hit those now, then we'll jump over to bench and we'll get to it. All right, Joe, so now I'm about to warm up on bench. When I have a bench single, I will take 1 rep at every weight before I go up. So I'll do 135, 185, 205, 220, everything's 1 rep. But today I have 4 sets of 6. So I'll start with sets of 6, 135, probably all the way up to 225. And then 225, I'll take 1 or 2 attempts or 1 or 2 reps, see how it's feeling. And then from there, I will decide on what weight I'm around for the day, and I'll probably pull under that. I pull under that so that I have the option to go up. And based on feeling, I don't want to load the heaviest weight right away because I don't want to load something that's too heavy just because I feel like I can do it. So first set is always gonna be a little bit lighter, and then we'll build from there. Or at least in the perfect world. So I'm gonna warm up on bench now. Like I said, I got a 4x6. I'm gonna just jump straight there with you guys, and then we'll keep it rolling. All right, so just got done warming up on bench. Hit 225. I feel like I could probably hit 255, 260 for my working sets. So this first one, I got 245 pounds loaded on the bar. Like I said, you wanna shoot under first, so you're not like draining yourself to a degree where you won't be able to finish all 4 sets. So I've got sets of 6, let's get to it. Thank you. y'all just saw set one. Moves pretty decent. One thing we're really focusing on bench, just having more control. You guys have seen me complain about my hips and whatnot before, and me and my coach are really just focusing on, while I'm benching 5 times a week, just keeping that control and focus throughout the whole set. That set right there was super clean. That'll make me better in the long run. Right now I had to back off the weight a little bit. I'm still doing 245 right now, but I'm saying, like, compared to what I would normally do, back off the weight a little bit, have more control, and really focus in. One way I figured out to do this, I changed the music that I listen to. Damn, I'm tired as fuck. I changed the music that I listen to on my sets on bench to, like, calm, relaxed music, like R&B and stuff. Whenever I listen to, like, super hype music, that's what I listen to during squat and deadlift. And shit, it works for that. But on bench, like I said, I need to really focus and focus on controlling the reps throughout the whole thing. So listening to slower music works for me. Stuff like that, you just gotta try out. You gotta try different things and see what works for you. So here we go, set two. I'm gonna hit 245 again, see where to go from there. My guy Isaiah pulled up on me.
What's good, YouTube?
You got that new drip. Let me see, hold one up real quick. That new body art.
Left chest, you know.
Left chest. You got the center chest? Let me see. You got the center chest. Check them all. I'm gonna put the link right here. The Instagram right here. I'll have the link first description in the bio. You can buy these shirts. Use my code, Izzy20. At checkout, save you some money. Support me on the back end. Sheesh. You got white. What is this, like a gray? Gray. Left chest, center chest. Alright guys, just wrapped up that powerlifting portion of the workout. Now is when I jump over to the gym side, if you will, and hit all my accessories. So I've been having some left pec, like right in my armpit, like irritation. It's just uncomfortable. It feels like when I'm benching, today was pretty good until like that last set. It's just a little bit uncomfortable. Feeling a little bit of pain, so I don't want to stress it too much. So I'm not going to do any stretching movements. The only stretch I'll do is like in a pressing movement. So no dumbbell flies, no cable flies, just to give you a kind of idea what I'm talking about. So like I said, I'm going to do a lot of pressing today. I'm going to start off with a dumbbell incline press. I'll do tricep extensions and probably a shoulder press, and then that'll be it. I got a bench tomorrow, so I try to keep my Friday sessions pretty short, as well as Lydia's about to drop off Xander so she could go to work. So I'll have him here with me in a little bit. So I'll show you guys what some accessories look like, and then maybe I'll do a voiceover and talk about why I do them the way that I do. So let's get to it.
Thank you.
All right, that's all y'all gonna get for this workout. I hope you guys enjoyed that. We got Xander in here getting his work in right now.